Hello friends, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. Today we gonna discuss about types of cache mode in lookup transformation. If you haven't watched last video of this video series, so I would strongly recommend to watch that video where you can understand about basics of lookup transformation. So let's start. So there are three types of cache mode available in lookup transformation. First is full cache. Second is partial cache and last is no cache. So let's start with full cache. So what is full cache? So this is used very often. In this option, entire reference table will be preloaded into the cache memory and lookup transformation will perform lookup from the memory instead of dataset. This works well when we have less number of record in lookup table. We need to remember cache connection manager can be used only this type of cache. In this case, when package starts, data will pull and keep into memory cache or file cache, and later only cache will be used, not database. We might not get the latest data from the database. Second is partial cache mode. So what is partial cache mode? So in this option, lookup transformation starts with empty cache. When a new row comes the data flow, the lookup transformation first check for matching values in its cache. If it's not found in the cache, then it will check in the lookup table. If the match is found in the lookup table, then the value will be cached into memory for next time. So if the lookup table is very big, then we can use this approach. So cache connection manager can't be used with this option, and advanced tab of lookup transformation will be enabled only in the case of partial cache, where we can configure cache size. Initially cache will be empty, so for each value first it check into cache. If not found, then it goes to the database. If found in database, then it store that value in the cache for next time. Startup time will be less than the full cache, but processing time will be longer, and it also required a lot of memory. And our last option is no cache. In this option, lookup transformation will not use the cache to store the lookup table at any stage. When a new row comes from the data flow, the lookup transformation directly checks in the lookup table for the matching values. Every time it will get the data from database. So go to on SSDT. So this package has been created in our last video. So double click on this lookup transformation. Then we can see cache mode. So in case of full cache, as we can see, cache connection manager has been enabled. Once we move to partial cache, then cache connection manager has been disabled. Once we move to no cache, then cache connection manager is also disabled. So as we have discussed, cache connection manager is only enabled when we are going to use cache mode is full cache. Next is when we move to partial cache, then our advanced tab has been enabled. As we can see, we can specify the cache size and we can also enable cache for rows with the no matching entries. When we move to our full cache, then advanced tab has been disabled. We cannot modify anything. And in case of no cache, as we can see, it's disabled. So here we can see this is our source table and it has total 5 rows, and this is our lookup table and it has 3 rows. So once we talk about full cache, then we can see whole data from lookup table will be cached into memory, as we can see in case of full cache. All 3 rows have been cached into memory. When we talk about partial cache, then in our source it will start from ID 1, so it will check in our partial cache. So initially it's empty, it goes to lookup data table and it will pick the value from there. So 1, then Joanne, and city is USA. For serial number 2, again we can see ID is 1, so ID 1 will be checked in our partial cache. So it's found, so there is no need to go to in lookup table, and it will pick directly from partial cache. When we move to serial number 3, then we can see ID is again 1, so there is no need to go to in lookup table. It will directly pick in partial cache memory. When we move to serial number 4, then we can see ID is 2. And here in partial cache memory, we don't have ID 2. So it will check first in our partial cache memory. If the value is not found in partial cache memory, then it will go to lookup table and pick the value from there. So 2, then Manish, then Delhi. So our second row has been cached in the memory. When we move to our serial number 5, then ID is 3. So first it will check in partial cache memory. It's not found. Then it goes to data table. So in lookup data table, we have 3. So 3 has been cached. So this is our partial cache. When we move to no cache. So in case of no cache, it will check from 1. So ID 1, initially no cache is empty. So it will directly move to lookup data table and it will pick the value from there. So Joanne and USA. So it is cached. When we talk about serial number 2, in source table, we have ID 1. So it will directly check in no cache. So in no cache, it will store the last fetched value. So as we have fetched ID 1, so ID 1 is available in no cache. So it will directly pick the value from no cache. When we talk about serial number 4, then it has the ID 2. And in no cache, we have fetched our last value is 1. So it will directly move to lookup data table and replace our existing value from memory. So 2, then Manish, and then Delhi. When we talk about serial number 5, then we can see ID is 3. 3 is not available in no cache. So it will directly goes to lookup data table and 3 is available over there. So it will pick and replace our existing value. So 3 has been replaced and it will store our last updated value. So I hope you have understand how we can use full cache, partial cache and no cache. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. And don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.